Hello, children. So we are here with the second last chapter of informatics practices for this academic year. We are going to learn a web browser. We all are very much aware of web browsers, so we don't again require a lot of explanation, but still definitions and the type of features, the advantages of web browser, little bit about settings, all these things we are dealing here. And at the last we have that societal impacts. You remember in 11th standard we learn that's add-ons to that. Okay, no. Now in between this, definitely you need to start with your project. So I'm going to attach one or two projects definitely along with this. When we meet on Thursday after watching this video, you make sure that you will dedicate at least half an hour or 1 hour in front of the laptop for starting your project. Now the project with what I am going to send to you may be little confusing or a little bit difficult for you, or a little above from your level of understanding, so that's perfectly fine. You can ask me every time, or you can even post it in the WhatsApp group, whichever way it is. But be active and make sure that by October, that means we have hardly 1.5 months for what I'm going to say, the end of October, the project has to be finished. In between, we will be definitely completing our this societal impacts, and we will have our record work completion also. Already we finished our from in pandas and everything. Now the SQL is there, and as I told, what you have to do in SQL is already done, so you just have to copy it properly into your Word. So that is left out. I'm just telling this before I start this video so that you know what to do for this month and for the next month. Okay, so make sure that you actively make use of time at the end. Don't let yourself be in trouble by saying that I didn't even start my project. That will be definitely going to be annoying, because if you finish it by October, then no matter what happens, whether we really meet with each other or not, our revision can go pakka. Okay, so that's one assurance I can give you from this side. Okay, so let's go with your chapter, that is web browser. Now all of you know what is a web browser, isn't it? So that is nothing but an application, a software application, an application package, if I wanted to say, I can say that, which help us to load the web pages from the web server to our client's machine. Or I can say, if I wanted to find out where is Python, I have to type www.python.org in a web browser. So now you know what is a web browser properly. A primary function of a web browser is to render HTML code. Render means to analyze hypertext markup language code. Each time a web browser loads a web page received from a web server, it processes the HTML. It need not be always HTML, can be any other language also, which may include text, links, references to images and other items, such as cascading style sheets. We say CSS in short form. Cascading style sheets are actually the extra, you know, that is extra web page, I can say, or extra additional add-ons to that web page, which always comes with XML or even with your Python web designing process. Okay, so all these things, when you load a web page, all these things are happening. And of course, other functions which is dedicated for the loading of that web page. Okay, so the browser processes these items and then renders them to your browser window. So definitely now what you're seeing in the background of this particular PowerPoint presentation, the PDF file which I have opened, is in web browser Mozilla Firefox. If I open the same thing in your Google Chrome, the interface is slightly different, isn't it? Because the settings, the style of approach in Google Chrome and in Mozilla are different. So these two are the common ones. We know the reason also why these two are common ones. We are going to deal with that. So we understood what is a web browser. Definition of a web browser is very important. Even though it seems very simple to you, if you are not able to answer that, you know what will happen. So the basic features of a good web browser. A good web browser Speed. A browser should be able to quickly load web pages. I prefer to use Mozilla Firefox personally. It's my favorite now, especially from March onwards when we had this Google Meet. The process of loading your Google Classroom, everything, even though it is supported by Google, and Google Chrome showed issues in my, you know, Windows 7 of OS. So I shifted to Mozilla. That's the time when I started using Mozilla Firefox. So speed is a matter for me. Maybe some of you don't have issues with Chrome, so these two have that comparisons, you know, what you call a kind of a rivalry or a comparison, which one to use best. But both are having its own good features, I think. So one is speed. A browser should be able to quickly load web pages, including multimedia files, no matter how dynamic the content. Nowadays, images and videos dominate online platforms, which require too much data to be processed. So depending upon which browser you're choosing, the speed matters. Okay, so speed, basic features of a good web browser, it's very self-explanatory, correct? Simplicity. A browser should have easy and simple user interface. It is like anybody who was working with another web browser, if they switch on to another one, they should be able to understand that one thing. Understand means how to go settings and everything, get take the history, change the color, change the background, everything. So that should be simple to understand. So that is one feature of a web browser. The user interface shouldn't take up a lot of screen space. That would be better used for the content that the user is trying to consume. There is too much of add-ons and too much of extension is not required actually. Depending upon your wish, you can add on. You understand the meaning of add-on, I suppose. The extensions which you can provide over here, this place. Okay. Securities. The browser should be also very secure, like browser, but it's the best is your Mozilla Firefox, because it has a typical firewall block for malware and malware, the phishing, everything is taken care by your Mozilla Firefox settings. So browser should also be very secure, as there are number of security threats available on internet which can lead to serious data breach and leakage. So if you're trying to download something malicious here, even though you don't have an antivirus software installed, if you're using your Mozilla Firefox, it will block it automatically if it seems to be not liable or reliable in nature, that particular exe file. Okay, so security, these three basic features, speed, simplicity, security, should be understood, should be well explained also. So the basic features of good web browser has been explained over here. Now comes major functions of a typical web browser. You all know, but in order to categorize it properly, we have set it. Definitely to send and receive internet resources, or send and access the web pages. Second is access web pages, render and display them. Okay. Internet resources can be any pages which is there. So the first and second is any same, similar. Select and save our favorite pages. Yes, it is available for us. We can always make it as a bookmark also. Print documents. The option should be there to print the document, isn't it? So definitely here, see, the option is there to print it. The option is there to make it the full screen. Like that, many options will be always there. Keep the records for our activity. Store information on the cloud. That means you should be always having a link with any of the cloud storage. That is your Google. If you are already signed into any cloud storage, definitely after completing the work here, if you wanted to store this into the cloud storage, that facility should be given by the web browser, which you know every web browser is giving. That is why we are able to save whatever you are downloading, or if even you can take a copy from the web page to your own file storage systems. Then install applications. The option to install all the installations happening is through your web browser's options only, isn't it? So these are the major functions of a typical web browser. Again, I don't think a lot of explanation required, because it's all self-explanatory. So once again, what is the major functions? Send and receive internet resources, access web pages, render and display them, select and save the favorite pages, print documents, keep the records of our activity, store information, and install applications. Okay, so that completes it. Now this videos, you know, I think we can just conclude this with this. How a web browser works. Now these things are not again explained very well in the syllabus, but it's good that you just understand. User interface, we call it as UI in short form. User interface is what we see, this one, user interface, a space where the user interacts with the web browser. Then a browser engine, that is your database. A browser engine queries and manipulates the rendering engine. That means if I type here something else, if you are type here something else, browser settings I have typed and kept over here, and I have classwork for all this. See your classworks I have given. In that case, each time when I go to this, there is an option to change the web browser display. So that is done in the browser engine. Rendering engine, that is after loading, trying to load the web pages in order to interact with what is that displays or what is it is displayed in the web page. It is done by the rendering engine. It interprets the HTML, XML or any designing programming language and images which should be displayed over here. Then networking. Suppose if you are in the net, internet, it handles all aspects of internet communication and security using HTTPS. You remember HTTPS, no? And FTP. What is FTP? File transfer protocol. That was not clearly explained because it's taken out of the syllabus. Then you have a JavaScript interpreter. Some of the installation requires some of this Java interpreter. They need .NET frameworks, etc. So when if you are downloading from a particular web browser which is not supporting all this, and they will ask download that also. I hope you might have seen such things. So you need a JavaScript interpreter. Then user interface backend for drawing basic widgets like combo boxes, windows, etc. If you want to design something online, then you need a user interface backend. A toolbox should be provided. That is only when you require such a option. Then storage. It manages user data such as cache cookies. You know the center in the each of the browser settings you have an option to store the history. All these things are there, no? That is coming under data persistence and storage. So we now know what is a web browser, what are the good features of a web browser, and how a web browser works. More than how a web browser works, actually they are dealing with what are things are contained in a web browser. User interface, browser engine, rendering engine, networking concept is incorporated, JavaScript interpreter, UI backend, and data processing slash storage. So if you just go through this, that is enough. Or if you want more explanation, okay, let us see. I don't think that much of explanation required, because more than that, it's high time to concentrate on our project. That is why we are just touching and going in all these things. So if you think this, I wanted to make it a little more simple. Yeah, we'll make it simple. Better way of how web browser works will be available definitely in the Google. We will search and find out. If this is okay, that is also fine. So thank you. We are going to check out with the next video where it will deal with the web browser settings. Okay, so I'm going to stop now. Thank you.